Hello everyone, I am the Lore Explorer, and this is Outer Wild. In today's loop, we will be talking about the interesting predator hiding deep inside our solar system. At first glance, anglerfish seem to be pretty straightforward, but as with everything in Outer Wilds, there is more if you are willing to dive a bit deeper and get eaten a few times for science. Thank you to the awesome admin in the Lore Explorer Discord, Deadpool, for the video suggestion. And as always, this video will contain spoilers for Outer Wilds. Normally when I make one of these videos, I will have thought real hard and I'm pretty confident in the conclusions I've made by the end of the video. But with anglerfish as a topic, we are facing a mystery to rival the eye. Where the heck did these things come from? How are they able to move through space at dark bramble? And how the heck do they sustain themselves? I'll do my best to answer these questions and just kind of track and follow the story of the anglerfish. The first time we are able to see anglerfish, they really don't appear like they will ever be an issue for us. A smallish sort of fish inside of a display case with a cool little glowy doodad on its head. It seems neat, really. The plaque outside its display case tells us that they found this specimen attached to the landing gear of one of the ships that happened to fly too close to Dark Bramble. The anglerfish was able to survive the entire flight from Bramble to Timberhearth in the vacuum of space. The Harthians suggest it does need a sort of minimal atmosphere to survive long term, but it's obvious that they can at least survive for a little while without fresh oxygen. So, all in all, these little guys are super cool, right? Well, unluckily, the next time we experience an anglerfish, it's not small and cute like the one we see at the Harthian Observatory. We find massive anglerfish inside the dimensional mess that is Dark Bramble. And I mean, these things are huge, easily able to devour our entire spaceship whole with one gulp, just like, Their size could be due to the strange dimensional effects here, but whatever the reason for their size, they are a danger to us. Luckily for us, evolution has sort of taken away their gift of sight from the anglers, but this seems to have heightened their hearing. If we thrust our engines just a little too much, these things chase us down with impressive speeds for such huge creatures. I mean, they'd probably be in some sort of record book here on Earth. But I don't think this is the normal strategy that they employ for hunting. They can't be sustaining themselves that way. It's not like we are sending in tons of Harthians as tribute. And Bramble doesn't seem to be inhabited by a bunch of noisy life forms for them to hunt down. We can tell that they have a hard time trying to find food. When we find our friend Feldspar, we can see an anglerfish was so hungry that it tried to eat a dark bramble seed, which then proceeded to kill it from the inside out. As most people know, in real life anglerfish use a growth dangling from its head to attract prey. I'm pretty sure the scientific name for it is called a dangly-doo. Deep sea anglerfish have what's called a glowy dangly-doo to attract creatures nearby to the light, just as it's, you know, sort of attracted us. And I'm thinking that the anglerfish use their glowing dangly-doo to attract the centipedes that we find infesting Dark Bramble, which, I mean, it's essentially a plant, so it probably has more bugs too just floating about that these things hoof up. I know in real life anglerfish aren't the size of freaking houses, but a lot of them do eat smaller prey like shrimp. Plus, they are very low energy exerting creatures, and some large creatures like whales also survive off eating very small creatures such as krill. So to me, it seems very likely the anglerfish mostly survive eating these centipedes and maybe other little bugs too. And they may even be taking in oxygen from the foggy environment around Dark Bramble, which sort of vaguely leads me to the next question. How is it possible for a fish to swim in what's essentially zero-g space? I bounced a lot of ideas about this one with people on the Discord, but I think I'm sticking with Occam's razor on this one. I don't think anglerfish store gas and expel it as a spaceship does or anything fancy. I think the mass of its giant tentacles moving backwards all at once provides an equal and opposite force projecting them forward, which is actually an interesting question. I propose we send up a fish with a little helmet on it into outer space to test it. I'm not obsessed with how anglers move, okay? I mean, it's you that's okay, I'm a little obsessed. Another pretty interesting thing about the anglerfish is the nest of eggs we find deep inside Bramble. All of the nodes in Dark Bramble, except this node that holds these eggs, are white. but this node glows red, and when we enter, we are met with three anglerfish guarding the entrance. A little past the protectors, we find a pretty big cluster of red eggs glowing bright. Each of the eggs are just about the size of our spaceship, and there's enough of them to essentially surround us. Interestingly, it seems like Dark Bramble itself has taken notice. It's as if like every one of these vines in the node is trying to reach out to surround the eggs as it did with the vessel. A few bonus facts before we dive into our final question. Our buddy Feldspar tells us that it appears anglerfish are pretty territorial creatures and tend to avoid each other. Bonus fact number two is that when an anglerfish is attacking, they actually have spikes that are surrounding their body that they extend to, I guess, look scary. And as someone pointed out on the Reddit, imagine trying to look scary when you're blind and have no sense of self. So, the final thing we have to talk about is kind of a big one. Where did the anglerfish originate from? I think it's very unlikely that the anglerfish originated from where they inhabit now. See, Dark Bramble is an interdimensional portal, and this portal leads to other Dark Bramble plants that, you know, did the same thing it did, which is devour whole planets and kind of take its resources. The anglerfish could originate from any of these connected planets. But I had a unique opportunity to ask the lead developer of Outer Wilds, Alex Beecham, in an email interview, the question of where they originate. So I asked just, you know, where did the anglerfish originate from? And his answer actually surprised me a bit. He said, the anglerfish may have come from Dark Bramble, or one of the planets it had infected, or they may have come from Ember Twin, which used to have water. Now, I know that didn't directly answer the question, but I think it's an excellent answer. I had never even really considered the possibility that they originated from Ember Twin. I mean, I know we do find an anglerfish skeleton there, but after all we've seen, it seems out of place once we find it. And even the Nomai seem to agree. They studied this fossil and determined that it died from a lack of food, and state that they do not think this anglerfish originate from here. But let's look at the whole picture. Not only did Ember Twin have water, it had an extensive cave system deep underground. Evolutionarily, it would make sense that they would lose their eyesight and grow their glowy dangly doos. In that environment of total darkness, light would surely attract prey, and we do know that there was prey to be had. We find evidence of other deep sea life in the form of fossils in these caves. The only stretch in this theory would be how that they would make their way to Dark Bramble after the, you know, the ocean is dried up. But we know that they can survive the flight there, since they survived the flight to Timbers. And if they can move in zero G like they do in Dark Bramble, they may be able to swim through space. But again, Dark Bramble and all its possible connections sort of make it really hard to pin down. It's just as likely that anglerfish come from one of those planets. But the fossils and evolutionary traits seem to actually point to Ember Twin, in my personal opinion. But that's mostly all I have on anglerfish. Thanks again to Deadpool for the video idea. And another member from the Discord actually had another cool idea. They started a petition to get Mobius Digital to add an Easter egg of yours truly to the game Outer Wilds. Now, I know it's a long shot, but I think it's worth that long shot. If you could, find the link in the description and go ahead and give it a signature, I'd really appreciate it. And as always, a special thank you to the members here on the channel. The support really does mean a lot to me and does help the channel grow. And all the rest of the usual business from YouTube, like, subscribe, and comment on that one time you brought your friend over and jump scared them with an angler, or whatever your anglerfish story is. For now, this is the Lore Explorer, just thanking you for watching the video to begin with.